Trent, mate, obviously disappointing result. Do you feel like it was a step backwards today or just a one-off?
Oh, I wouldn't say a step backwards might be a bit dramatic. You know, we got taught a good lesson today about, you know, a seasoned good team. You know, guys in their mid-20s with hardened bodies who, you know, have played deep into September for the last 5 or 6 years. So the good thing was, you know, we got taught a good lesson in work rate. I thought their work away from stoppage offensively and then defensively, if we were able to turn it over, was first class. And that's probably what, you know, why they've been so good. So that's the positive we can take out of today, was some of that learning and being able to expose some of our younger guys in particular to that.
Yeah, was that the message post game from you? Just a learning experience?
Yeah, look, at the end of the day, like, probably for us, North Lonnie is where we want to get to be like that, and that's going to take a little bit of time, you know, so. Yeah, it's all about learning. What did we learn out of today, and you know, what can we take away from it, and also implement that into our last four games, and then rolling into next pre-season as well. So, you know, yeah, we're chasing that, and use today as that learning tool for that.
Yep. There was a lot made last time you played North Lonnie. You matched up really well against them up at UTAS. What was the biggest difference between that game and today? What kind of let you down in that aspect?
I think in that last game, especially towards the back end of it, we really controlled the ball at the source really well and won a lot of it, and were able to, you know, get it going our way and, you know, use our speed up forward. So I think I'm not sure off the top of my head what the stoppage numbers were today, but it just felt like, you know, they were able to shape out of stoppage a lot better. You know, they were able to release back and use their runners. You know, I thought Ponting was really dangerous, especially out the back as a release from stoppage, and you know, they were able to control the game in that regards, but then also get it into their forward line as well and maintain it in, which is, you know, it's what everyone likes to do, is try and get, you know, forward entries and then use your pressure. And we weren't able to get that going well enough today. You know, we were probably a little bit too shallow in entries. You know, we kicked to their extra at times behind the ball a lot, and you know, we probably didn't get it as deep as we like, and then in turn we weren't able to get our pressure going.
Well, it was probably a tough day for your midfield group going up against one of the better midfielders on the comp, but I thought a few guys in there probably held their own. I thought Blake Grant was good throughout the day.
Yeah, we identified Blake. Blake was probably, you know, our best player on the day. You know, over the course of 120 minutes, I thought he was outstanding. Will Campbell at the back end of the game was really good, and Lockie Clifford as well through the last quarter. So really good for our guys to be able to, you know, play against Cox Goodyear, Taylor Whitford when they're in there, especially, you know, not having Ryan with them, obviously with Rhino out for the season. It's been, it's not a blessing in disguise, because obviously we want Ryan playing every week, but a chance for Blake Grant. You know, Blake Grant started off the year as a pressure forward, then we moved him up to the wing, and now he's playing on ball. So, you know, it's only going to make Blake Grant a better player over the next 2-3 years to having this exposure as well.
Yeah, I thought probably North Lonnie probably controlled the game in that first half, and then that probably, I think you kicked the goal in the first minute of the third, and then it was kind of all North Lonnie, and I think they kicked 6 in a row. What was the message at halftime, and then what, I guess, can the boys learn from that as to stop momentum when other teams get on that momentum train?
I think at halftime we identified that we wanted to even up the numbers across the ground a lot more. You know, we wanted to hold 6 forwards ahead of the footy, so when we did get it in, we had a bit more shape there or personnel to pressure it to get it on the ground. So yeah, we didn't want any extra numbers across the ground, which I think we just wanted to get our defensive actions first and foremost, and across the first 3 quarters, you know, we try and hold the opposition marks in space down, so that means we're defending, and the first 3 quarters it was really unacceptable, that number, for how we've defended, especially over since the last time we played North Lonnie. We've had a really good patch of games defensively, so our tackle numbers were down, and that number was higher, their marks in space, so we got that down in the last quarter, and I think the last quarter goals wise was even, I think. So it was pleasing that we were able to play the game out that way, and it just shows that you can't, you know, the old give an inch, take a mile sort of thing. You can't let a good team especially get the game on their terms and let them do what they want to do, or the result that happened today happens.
Yeah, thought it would have been pretty easy for you guys to kind of go into the last quarter and just, you know, go with emotions, but to your credit, you thought the game out I think you won the last quarter by a goal. Were you pleased with the effort for the guys in the last quarter?
Yeah, absolutely. But at the end of the day, we don't want it to take to three-quarter time. And you know, we didn't give the boys a rocket or anything like that. There was no sprays or anything like that. It was like, you know, you're able to show them the stats. We go, well, look at this number of marks in space. Like, that's not us. That's not how we've been playing. So, and, you know, let's just get back to what we've been doing really well over the last little period, even for 30 minutes, so you can take something out of it. So, yeah, like, not great to only play 30 minutes of footy. You know, we want to be playing 120. So, but, you know, we learn from it.
Yeah, I thought Marcus Davies held Barton McCullough really well in the first half, and then he probably just got off the leash at the end of the third and bit in the last again. Were you pleased with Marcus's game?
Yeah, Mark, I think we had to roll some matchups over in the second and in the second half, obviously being down in those rotations. But yeah, it was great to see Marcus cut and move with the ball in hand today. Like, you know, he's obviously coming back from that PCL injury, and you probably, I suppose, as most players do, it's just getting confidence and continuity in your body. But it was just really good to see his sideways lateral movement and taking the game on. You know, he ran and carried today, and I thought, you know, we saw that as well in Sam Rice as well. So good to have those two more of our more experienced guys get a little bit of confidence in their body back as well and play well today.
Yeah, the bye next week, Mark, and then four games to go for the rest of the season. Is there going to be any changes, like, in terms of game style or playing guys in different positions, or is it just all systems go as normal for the last 4 weeks of the year?
No, all systems go. You know, it's not queuing the rack time. You know, we don't want to mail it in. We've got four games that we'll be preparing as we do every week, and you know, because, you know, if you have a really good last month of the season, get those things right, it kickstarts into your next pre-season as well, and you know, that's what we're about. Obviously, you've got half an eye on next year as a coach, and you know, you're starting to think about a few things, but we're not looking too far forward. You know, we really want to finish out the season strongly, and I think as a group we deserve to as well, like, for the work that we've put in over the last little bit and the way that we've been really competitive, that I think, you know, we're not, you know, really determined to not take any backward steps in the product that we put out on the field each week.
Yeah, like, Jake Doran came off with a nasty arm injury in that last quarter.
Yeah, so he's a dislocated shoulder, so it hasn't gone back in. He's just gone off in the ambulance, so hopefully that gets sorted. So, but I'd say, you know, that's Jake done for the season, which is unfortunate. Lukey Graham had a head knock, and Matty Code had just a corky in his knee. So, you know, by the end, we were down to, had those three off the ground, so one rotation. So that was another pleasing thing, especially the second half, only having two on the bench and the guys still digging in and playing the game out.
Carl, mate, no doubt pretty happy with that one.
Yeah, it was in the end. Probably played three and a half quarters today. We really haven't played a four-quarter performance yet this year, so three and a half, we'll take that.
Yeah, put your race out of the blocks early, and then you controlled the first half really well, and then in the third quarter, I think you kicked six in a row. Were you pleased with that third quarter?
Yeah, well, I spoke about putting scoreboard pressure on today.
Yep.
Probably the first half we didn't do that. I think we kicked 6-9 or something off,
yep,
something around that. So we had to put scoreboard pressure on it to get the game over and done with. And I think in the third quarter we were able to do that a little bit better, which probably put us in a good position.
Yeah, only the one goal in the last. Were you disappointed with the way you finished the game out?
Yeah, I was a little disappointed. Probably the first 15 to 20 of the last, we weren't great, and we just couldn't adapt to the way that they were playing. We weren't able to get any ball in a hand, really, and couldn't get it into our forward half. Once we did that in the last 10 or so minutes, once again we looked okay.
Yeah, thought your forward line functioned really well today. Bennett and Bannister and yourself and Bart came in the game in the second half.
Yep.
Were you pleased with the way the forward line functioned?
Yeah, something we learnt. There's some things that we try to put in place after the Lonnie game that we thought we could do a little bit better, and I think we did today. You know, we got a little bit more pressure in there. I thought that Dakota was good. He had some things that he needed to work on coming out of the Launceston game, and it was really positive the way he was able to do that, and probably didn't lay as many tackles, but the pressure effort to get to the next one was quite good, and we were able to force him maybe three or four times out of bounds in the full, which is something we haven't done of late, so that was good to see.
Yeah, I thought your midfield was really good today, and probably Ponting was probably one of your better contributors.
Yeah, we gave him a rest in the last quarter because he did a mountain of work. I thought he was great. He tackled well in and under, and then was able to release on the outside and give Cousins and Cox Goodyear the footy, so I thought he was good as well.
Yeah. Your running link off half back was really impressive. I thought guys like Richard Salda and Jay Firm were really good in that aspect.
Yeah, Lonnie played a pretty good brand of footy last week and were able to stifle our ball movement. It was something we worked on, so it was pleasing to see that it came to fruition today. We were able to get some run and link from behind.
Yep, no doubt a big milestone for the club today in Bradcock's Goodyear's 150th. Yeah. Seeing it shared off there and the response you got from not only your blokes but the Tigers, I think he's a pretty well-respected guy within the competition.
Yeah, I got the question whether we brought it up. You know, 150 games and life membership, you've got to bring that sort of stuff up. There's no one in our group that has done that. It's a really good achievement. Personally for Brad, from where he started our footy club to where he is now, the leader and the captain, he's come a really long way and it's super effort and played his role again today. I thought he was good. He doesn't play a bad game, so super effort.
Yep. Anyone else stand out in particular today or just an all-round?
Yeah, pretty much an all-round effort, I thought. I thought our back six were quite good to keep them to that scoreline. We probably wanted to keep them a little bit lower as our goal going into the last, so we let a little bit through, but I thought our back six together worked as a unit quite well. And obviously, as you said, Ponting was pretty good as well.
Obviously you got the win last week against Swanee, but it was a pretty tight game. What was the review during the week? Was there obviously things you took out of that you can do a bit better?
Yeah, there was. I mean, the boys mentally just took something from that game and thought, well, in that last quarter, that's how we play footy.
Yep.
Probably before that, we were coasting a little bit. So, let's hope that game puts us in good stead for the next four that we've got. It did today, so that's good. We've just got to keep taking steps forward to where we want to get to by the end of the year.
Yep. Another tough challenge in Glenorchy next week. I think they lost to Glenorchy the other day. So obviously they'll be on the rebound next week. What do you make of those guys?
Yeah, tough to win at KG5. We did it earlier in the year. Probably only my second win there. It's a tough ground. They play a very similar brand of footy to us. They want to take it on. They want to take risks. So we're going to have to be on defensively first and foremost. And we've got some really good players in Bowden, Webb, Mott. So we're going to have to be on our game.
Yeah, 4 or 5 weeks now. It was the back end of the year, and we hit finals. Is there just a lot of recovery now? I guess with just looking at blokes, make sure they're primed and ready to go.
We've got 4 Hobart trips out of the 5 games left, so pretty big workload for our boys. So we'll have to monitor their load during the week, but will hold us in good stead, I think, for the back half of the year, considering we have the bye in the second last round and then Lauderdale. So we've got a pretty heavy load, so we're going to have to monitor that. Yep. But
no doubt this is a time you guys really want to hit your straps and get raring and ready to go for the big time.
Yeah, you want to be playing your best footy like all the time, I guess. But when it comes to the pointy end of the year, you've got to be playing your best footy. It's been well noted we haven't been playing our best footy, so as I said, mentally last week I think we took a step forward in what it takes to play good footy, and today a little bit came to fruition, but let's hope we take another step next week.
Yeah, look like you got through with a clean bill of health.
Yeah, all good. Yep. Yeah, we tried a few different things. We put Tom Donnelly forward in the last quarter. We put Ponting forward to give him a break, so tried a few little different things in the last that some worked, some didn't, but got through unscathed. Yep.